In this video, we are going to solve the problem that is on polynomial. Okay, now the first question is find the zeros of the polynomial, that is quadratic polynomials, and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. Okay, now you know that the zeros means the roots of any equation, and if I take the equation here, if you want to find out the coefficient, then the coefficient of x square will be 1 and coefficient of x will be 2. Okay, so for this equation x square minus 2x minus 8, if we want to find out the zeros or the roots, and we want to find out the relationship between zeros and the coefficient, at first we have to find out the values of x. If we get the values of x here, then ultimately we can say that the values of x are the roots or the zeros of this equations. Okay, so at first we have to know the middle term factor, that means we have to know the factorize a polynomial by splitting the middle term. Okay, if I take the equation of quadratic polynomial, the basic equation, that is x square plus bx plus c. Okay, so if the equation is x square plus bx plus c, and you want to find out the factor, you want to factorize a polynomial, that means this polynomial, by splitting the middle term, here we have to assume first the numbers p and q, okay, such that p plus q will be equal to p, and p multiplied with q will be equal to c. Okay, that means we have to break this number into the multiplication of two numbers. Okay, and the coefficient of x, that means here b, will be equal to the number that already multiplied to find out the value of c. We are taking this method and applying in this equation. Okay, so the equation is, so here the c means, if you write the general equation, that is x square plus bx plus c, so here it is c, so c here equal to 8. Okay, and we know c equal to p and then q, p multiplied with q. Okay, so we have to find out the factors of 8. So what are the factors? 2 and then 4. So 4 and 2 gives 8. And the next condition is b should be equal to the sum of p and q. Okay, so if we take the numbers 2 and 4 as p and q, and write here b equal to 2 plus 4, then it is not correct. So how to do it? We can do one thing, that b equal to 4 and then plus, and inside the bracket it will be minus 2, that means 4 minus 2. Okay, so for the equation x square minus 2x minus 8, it will be x square and then minus, and then 8 means 4 into 2, 8 means 4 into 2, and if we write 4 minus 2, then we will get 2. So we can write basically 4 minus 2, and outside the bracket is x and then minus 8. So it will be x square and then it will be minus 4 and the x and then minus and minus plus 2x and 8. Okay, so basically we got x square minus 4x plus 2x, that gives us minus 2x and minus 8. Okay, got it? So now look at this equation. It is that, so at first we are finding x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8, and then we are taking common from this term, that is x. So inside the bracket that is x minus 4 and then plus 2, then inside the bracket x minus 4. So here we can write x minus 4 as a common and the rest x plus 2 inside the bracket. Okay, so here you got that x minus 4 and x plus 2 here. Okay, so therefore the zeros, therefore if you want to find out the values, so you have to write x minus 4 and then x plus 2 equal to 0. So we can write here x minus 4 equal to 0. We can write x minus 4 equal to 0 and we can write x plus 2 equal to 0. Okay, and next we can write here x is equal to 4 and from here we can write x is equal to minus 2. Okay, so ultimately we are getting the values of x 2, that is minus 2 and 4. Okay, so now once we got the values of x, that is one is 4, another one is minus 2, and already we know the solution will be the roots or the zeros of this equation. So that means for the equation x square minus 2x minus 8, one root is 4 and another root is minus 2. Okay, got it? Now the second part is relationship between the zeros and the coefficient. Okay, so what are the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient? Already you know sum of zeros, one is sum of zeros and another one is product of zeros. Okay, to sum of zeros for this equation x square minus 2x minus 8, okay, where the values of x are 4 minus 2, so we can write that 1 0 is 4, another 0 or root is the minus 2. Now we know the formula of sum of zeros, that is equal to and then in the numerator it is minus coefficient of x and in denominator that is coefficient in x square. Okay, so what is the coefficient of x? That is minus 2, and then in denominator coefficient x square, that is 1 here. So basically we have to put minus because the formula is minus coefficient of x and then in denominator coefficient of x square. So basically we got minus and inside the bracket minus 2 and in denominator 1. So from here we will get 2. Okay, so the sum of zeros for this equation x square minus 2x minus 8 will be 2. And what for the product of zeros? We know product of zeros means constant term by coefficient of x square. So here constant term is minus 8 and below it is coefficient of x square, that is 1. So ultimately we got product of zeros as minus 8. Okay, got it? So if you want to find out the relationship between zeros and coefficient, then apply those formulas. Okay, and if directly asks me to find out the sum of zeros and product of zeros, then ultimately we can write, you know, if one root is alpha and another root is beta for polynomial, then the sum of zeros will be alpha plus beta and product of zeros will be alpha into beta. So if we put the value for alpha plus beta that will be 4, and then minus 2, that means 2 here. And if we want to find out the value of alpha beta, so that will be, the value of alpha is 4 and the value of beta is minus 2, so ultimately you get minus 8. Okay, so if the question is to find out the polynomial of a particular equation, then find out the value of variable first. If you have the variable, then we become to know that the roots or zeros of the polynomials are the values of x here. Okay, and if the question is to find out the sum of zeros, then directly we can put this. And if the question is find out the relationship between zeros and coefficient, then we have to apply using those formulas, coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, okay, and in front it minus. Okay, so again I am recapping that if the question is to find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial and find out sum of zeros and product of zeros, then directly we can do using the formulas. Okay, for sum of zero, that will be alpha plus beta, and product of zeros, that will be alpha into beta. Okay, and if the question is verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient, then we have to apply the all those formulas to find out the relationship. Okay, because we know the relationship, here. Okay, so ultimately the formula is there, all these formulas to directly find out the sum of roots and product of roots. And if the question is to find out the relationship, then sum of roots, in sum of roots you have to put the formula this, and to find out the product of roots you have to find out the formula this. Okay, got it? So here is another question. The question is 4u square plus 8u, which is the quadratic polynomial. Here constant part is 0, so we can write it this equation 4u square plus 8u plus 0. Okay, so it is a quadratic polynomial. Here also we have to find out the same thing, we have to find out the relationship. So therefore the what will be the zeros here? So here from this equation we are taking common 4u, and inside the bracket it is u plus 2. And if we write it and make equal to the 0, then the equation will be 4u, and inside the bracket u plus 2 equal to 0. So already you can say that 4u equal to 0, and on the another side u plus 2 equal to 0. From this we can write u equal to minus 2, and from this you can write 0 by 4 equal to 0. So from here we are getting two values of u, one is 0, another one is minus 2. So you can say that 0 and minus 2 are the roots or the zeros of this equation 4x square plus 8u. Okay, so we can say that alpha, we can say that one value, that is 0, that will be equal to alpha, and beta equal to minus 2. Okay, and again if we have to find out the sum of zeros directly, then we can add those roots, so we will get alpha plus beta minus 2, and product of roots, that will be 0, because 0 multiplied by minus 2 will be 0. Okay, and if the question is to find out the relationship, then we have to find out the result or the relationship by using this formula. Okay, got it? So here if you use this formula, so it will be equal sign, then minus, then in the upper side it will be coefficient of u, so coefficient of u will be 8, and in the denominator that is coefficient of u square, so coefficient of u square means 4. So if we cut it, then we will get minus 2. Okay, so the basically the sum of zeros will be minus 2. Okay, and product of zeros will be same as 0 by 4 because constant term equal to 0 and 4 means coefficient of square. So 0 by 4 that gives us 0. Okay. So basically we got that. Basically we got the sum of zeros and product of zeros in zeros using two methods. Okay. Now the second question. The question is find a quadratic polynomial each with the given number as sum and product of is 0 respectively. Okay. So here the number given, one is 1 by 4, another one is minus 1. Okay. So here written is that 1 by 4 is the sum and minus 1 is the product of zeros already mentioned in the question. Okay. So if we have the sum as 1 by 4, then we can write that alpha plus beta equal to 1 by 4. If alpha and beta are the roots or zeros of this equation. Okay. So 1 by 4 equal to alpha plus beta we can write, and also you can write alpha into beta equal to minus 1. That is the product of zeros. So we are getting this according to the question. Okay. So if we have this, then we know what is the equation, basic equation to find out the exact quadratic polynomial. What is the equation? Equation is x square minus alpha, we are writing again. So the basic equation is, to form the exact equation, x minus alpha plus beta and then x and then alpha plus beta equal to 0. So here it is x square minus alpha plus beta given here 1 by 4 and then x and then plus and alpha beta is minus 1. So ultimately it will be minus 1. So we can write it x square minus 1 by 4x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, because plus minus gives us minus. So ultimately we got x square 1 minus x square minus 1 by 4x minus 1 equal to 0. So basically we got x square minus 1 by 4x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so if we put the LCM as 4, we get 4x square minus x and then minus 4 equal to 0. Okay, got it. Okay, because if we find out the LCM here, it will be, it gives us 4. So we got 4x square minus x minus 4. Okay, and then cross multiplication. So 0 will be multiplied with 4, so it gives us 0. Okay, and it is 1 below of 0, so it gives us 4x square minus x minus 4. Okay, so ultimately we got the equation, that is 4x square minus x minus 4 equal to 0. So it is the quadratic polynomial whose sum of zeros is 1 by 4 and product of zeros is minus 1. Okay, I think it is clear. Okay, so do it carefully and watch it. If you have the problem, then pause it and watch the video again. Now the next question is, if the zeros of the polynomial, that is x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 1, are a minus b, a and a plus b, then find a and b. Okay, so already in this question we are given the zeros here or the roots here. One is a minus b, another one is a, and then next one is a plus b. Okay, so all these are the zeros or the roots. Okay, in this polynomial x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 1, basically this polynomial is a cubic polynomial as the degree is 3. Okay, so now the basic aim is to find out the sum of the zeros here. Okay, so what will be the sum of the zeros? We know the sum of the zeros is the sum of all these value. Okay, so that means a minus b plus a plus a plus b. Okay, and this equals to, we know the formula, that will be minus of minus coefficient of x square, that is minus 3, and at below in denominator it will be the coefficient of x cube, that means 1. Okay, so basically we are getting here plus 3. Okay, now on the left hand side we are getting minus b plus b cuts off, and we have 3a. So basically 3a equal to 3, so that means a equal to 3 by 3, so basically we got 1. Okay, so ultimately we got that the value of a will be 1 here. Okay, so the value of a will be 1 here. Okay, now the next part, what is the next part? The next part is the product of the zeros. So what do you mean by the product of the zeros here? We know the product of the zeros means basically here we can write a minus b, then a, and then multiplied by a plus b equal to, what will be? It will be minus constant term in the numerator. The constant term here is 1, and in denominator it will be coefficient of x cube. Here it is 1. In x cube the coefficient of x cube is 1 here. So basically minus 1 we are getting for the product of zeros. And the left side it will be, here look at a minus b and a plus b, so it is equal to a square minus b square, and outside it will be a. Okay, and now previously got that a equal to 1, so putting the value a equal to 1 here, so we get 1 square, then b square, and outside that is 1 equal to minus 1. So basically it is 1 square minus b square equal to minus 1. Okay, so if you write it properly, so it will be 1 square minus b square equal to minus 1. So we get b square equal to 1 plus 1, that means 2. So ultimately the value of b will be root over 2. Okay, got it? So the value a and b is, the value of a is, sorry, the value of a is 1 and the value of b is root 2. Okay, once we are getting these values we can find out all the roots here. So the first root, so the first root is a minus b, so that will be 1 minus, and inside the bracket the value of b, that is root 2. So basically we are getting 1 minus root 2. Okay, next one is a, so a means 1, and then the next or the last root is a plus b, so that means a means 1 and plus, and then b means root 2. Okay, so ultimately we are getting that all the roots are 1 minus 2, 1, and 1 plus root 2. Okay, got it? So do it carefully, it is clear to you? Okay, okay, now the next part. So now the question is, divide the polynomial px, that is px equal to here the cubic polynomial, that is x cube minus 3x square, then 5x, then minus 3, and gx, that is x square minus 2. So we have to divide x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3 using the divisor x square minus 2. Okay, so look at the procedures. Okay, so what are the procedures here? Look at very carefully. One thing is that whenever that
whenever we are dividing any expression, we have to write the expression, that means dividend here and divisor here. Already we know. Now look at the process. At first it is x cube minus 3x square. Okay. So always we have to look for the first term here. The first term is here x cube. Okay. And the divisor is x square minus 2. So if we multiply x with x square minus 2, then we will get x cube, x into x square, that is x cube, and minus 2 into x, that means minus 2x. Okay, here. So ultimately we are getting here x cube and here minus 2x. Okay, and now we have to make the opposite sign here to cut the terms. So if we change the sign here, so it will be minus for x cube and it will be plus for 2x. Okay, so x plus x cube here and minus x cube, it will cut out, and here it will be plus 5x and minus, sorry, plus 2x, it gives us 7x. Okay, so ultimately in the next step we are getting here, it is here, that is minus 3x square, then we are getting 7x. Okay, and it is minus 3 here. Now again we have to look for the same thing, it is 3x square. So if we multiply minus 3 with this expression, we are getting minus 3x square. Okay, first, and then minus 2 and minus 3, we are getting plus 6. Okay, so also we have to change the sign here. So it was minus, so it will be plus, and it is plus, it will give us minus. So basically this term and this term will be omitted for opposite sign, and it will be minus 3 and minus 6 gives us minus 9 here, and 7x will remain as it is, 7x. So basically as a reminder, we are getting here 7x minus 9, and quotient is here x minus 3 here. Okay, if you are confused about the result, it is right or wrong, then multiply remainder with quotient, you will get this dividend. If you are not getting this dividend, then you will think that your procedure is wrong. Okay, so to check the answer, multiply quotient and remainder, you will get this answer. Okay, so thank you very much. Okay.